Hi everybody, my name is Luis Vargas and now I'm going to show you how to create a web application using Polymer tar. What is Polymer? Before beginning, I would like to tell you what is Polymer. If you look the definition of Polymer in Wikipedia, you're going to find this. A polymer is a large molecule or macromolecule composed of many repeated subunits. What is Polymer Dart? Polymer Dart is a set of comprehensive UI and utility components for building web applications using repeated subunits called web components. What are web components? From Mozilla, you can find that a web component consists of several separate technologies, and you can think of web components as reusable user interface widgets that are created using open web technology. They are part of the browser and so they do not need external libraries like jQuery or Dojo. An existing web component can be used without writing code simply by adding an importing statement to an HTML page. Web components use new or still developing standard use browser capabilities. In other words, it's just simple HTML inside HTML. So let's create our first application. First, you need to open your Dart editor. Thereon, you need to go to File, New Project, and in here you are going to select a Polymer web application. Later on, you are going to set a name. In this case, we are going to set my first Polymer app. I'm just going to put a number. In this case, I'm just going to put 00 for the beginning. We cannot put numbers. Okay. Let's put it in here. 00. Oops. 00. And this is going to be our 00 tutorial. So let's click finish. You'll have, voila, you have created your first application, your first Polymer application. This one you should have next hierarchy. It should have the beginning folder with the name of the application, the packages, the PokeSpec log, the PokeSpec YAML, libraries, main application, main app.html, web, images, applet, file icon, index, robots, and styles. And some other files that we are going to talk later. By default, the first opened file is index.html. As any file, this one is composed by two main parts, head and body. Inside head, you're going to find some meta tag elements. Those one define the metadata information that informs the browser how to display content, what files should be cached when reloading the page, and to search engine some keywords and other important information about the application. The other tab you're gonna find are links. This tag is used to import icons, like in this case. They also import style sheets. We don't have any style sheet down here. We have a style sheet. And it also imports HTML using the rel import. This feature is only it's only for HTML5 browsers. Not all browsers support these features. Only the latest one. As you can see, if you do control click in for example into Roboto HTML, you're gonna be redirected to Roboto HTML. And again, I'm just gonna control click. And in here, you're gonna see that this HTML5 is importing importing the fonts from Google APIs. Just importing a CSS file. The other import is for main application. In this one, you're gonna find the code of our application. The second part of the index HTML is the body. In here, you're gonna find the main application, or just main app. This tag is the definition, or just the definition of the web component. In here, we're instantiating the web component. And the other tag inside body is a script. And this script is type application dart. This script contains this part, export package polymer init.dart. In here, if we go to init.dart, occurrences, let's see. Nothing. Oh, here. Leap. Is this one? You're gonna see that this file just contains a main function. Every Dart application begins with a main function, even web applications. And this main function just called to init polymer. This init polymer is in charge of beginning the application or bootstrapping the Polymer application. You can find the documentation. It initializes the Polymer application, basically. It looks for observables, it looks for other Polymer content, and later on create the application. Let's back to main application.html. Let's make it bigger. Okay, this application contains some tags. This one contains a link import, which is importing polymer.html. All Polymer HTML applications need to import this. All Polymer components import Polymer HTML. It also imports the paper input HTML. This one is a web component created by Google, and it's for creating a text box with some styling. Inside body, you are going to find also a Polymer element declaration. In here, you are declaring the application that you are going to create. In this case, the name of the application is going to be main application, or just main app. Inside Polymer element, you're going to find template. And inside template, you're going to find a style, some components. And those components, in this case, a paper input and a paragraph. As you can see, this paper input has a label type something. And also, it has a attached an event onKeyApp. Whenever the user do onKeyApp, this function is gonna be called the reverse text function, which is defined in here in the main app dart. Reverse, and the second part, you're gonna find the reverse and reverse expression. This expression says Polymer that every time that this variable defined in my app is changed, this variable is gonna render again. This expression is gonna be rendered again. Let's go inside main app dart. Inside main app dart, you're gonna find some imports, importing dart HTML, importing PRP input, and also importing Polymer dart. The beginning is an annotation custom tag with the name of the application. This name should be the same as the index HTML application. Let's close those. So those names should coincide. This main app should be coincide with this one. Later on is the declaration or the of the object of the class. This class is gonna be main app, and this one extends Polymer element. All custom Polymer elements should extend this other class. Inside this class, you're gonna find three things: observable, a string reverse, which declares the variable reverse and says it's type string, and also it says that it's an observable. Observable means every time it changes, the HTML is gonna change also. And you initialize this variable with an empty string. You have main app.create. This one is the named constructor create, and all Polymer element should instantiate this constructor and also call a super create. And finally, we have the reverse text, a function or method. This method is called remember from index.html on key app paper input element. This method, every time that that the user do a key app, this method is gonna be called. Inside this method, you're gonna find the logic of this method, which is every time the target, it means the paper element, the paper input element, it has a key app, the target value, get the value, split it using an empty string. That means getting the charge. Those three means getting the charge of the input, reverse the charge, and joining again. All those it's already inside Jard. You don't need to import any other library, any important library. All of this is inside Dark Core. That's why you don't need to import Dark Core. It's already auto imported. And finally, you're gonna find commented some other useful method that we're gonna talk later. So let's begin our application. To begin our application, the best way of doing this is just doing right-click index.html and then run in Dartium. This one is gonna open Dartium. What is Dartium? Dartium is just Chromium plus DartVM. Sorry. Okay, here is our application. This application just contains a simple input text box and a reverse. Every time that you key up, the text is gonna be reversed. As you can see, this text is the reverse of this one. And that's it. I hope you like it, and don't forget to share this presentation. Thank you.